For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
5.5 years after the murder of Honduran land defender Berta Cáceres, one of the key masterminds behind the crime was finally brought to justice. Roberto David Castillo, the former president of Desarrollos Energéticos S.A. DESA Company, was found guilty for the assassination of Cáceres. The High Court in Tegucigalpa issued the ruling on July 5th after a 49-day trial. Hundreds of records, chats, and audios were presented in the court demonstrating the clear role of Castillo in the murder. Castillo's sentence is set to be announced on August 3rd.
Bueno, es un sentimiento, yo creo, de un poco más de tranquilidad. Son 5 años de pelear por justicia, son 5 años bastante cansados, y este es un logro, es un camino más, es un paso más de justicia.
Berta Cáceres was assassinated in her home in La Esperanza, Honduras, on March 2nd, 2016. She was the co-founder and coordinator of the Civic Council of Popular and Indigenous Organizations of Honduras, COPIN. Following the coup d'etat in 2009, she emerged as an important national leader in the movement for the refoundation of Honduras. Leading up to her assassination, Cáceres had been subjected to a campaign of threats and acts of physical violence by members of the Honduran security forces, as well as employees of DESA. This was due to her active role in the resistance to the construction of the hydroelectric project Agua Zarca on the Gualcarque River that is sacred to the indigenous Lenca people.
Hemos visto la participación de funcionarios del Estado en esta persecución y ataques sistemáticos que vivió Berta Cáceres antes de su muerte, pero también la omisión al deber de protección que tenía el Estado porque era una persona beneficiaria de medidas cautelares, de medida de protección, y que incumplió con ese papel.
Since her assassination 5.5 years ago, her organization and her family have fought tirelessly to uncover the truth behind her assassination and bring those responsible to justice. In November 2018, 7 people were convicted who directly participated in the execution of the crime. But COPIN insisted that justice meant more than convicting those that pulled the trigger, and doubled down in their struggle to bring those who financed, planned, and organized the crime to justice. Castillo was arrested on March 2, 2018, was long considered the link between the hitmen and the financiers of the crime. This was shown through evidence presented by COPIN's legal team and by the Public Prosecutor's Office of Honduras. In a statement released by COPIN following the verdict, they stated that the ruling was a people's victory for justice for Berta, a step towards breaking the pact of impunity. The statement released by the organization also calls for the cancellation of the concession for the Agua Zarca project. This concession was at the heart of the dispute between DESA and COPIN, with Berta Cáceres playing a key role in the sustained resistance to the project. COPIN and the community of Rio Blanco that lives next to the Gualcarque River allege that the concession was granted illegally. The illegal granting of the concession is currently being contested in court in the Gualcarque fraud case. 16 public functionaries, including David Castillo, have been charged with fraud and abuse of authority. In addition to Berta, several other members of COPIN and the Rio Blanco community were assassinated during the years of resistance to Agua Zarca. The organization continues to suffer attacks due to their determined struggle for justice for Berta and their continued opposition to the Agua Zarca project. COPIN has celebrated the ruling and emphasized that justice is built by the people in daily work, along with the defense of our territories and the realization of our projects of life, and the constant struggle against inequality and injustice.